Hi, I'm Shannon Wyman, the Scientific Communications Manager at Keystone Symposia, and today I will be speaking with Dr. Francisco Quintana of Harvard Medical School and the Broad Institute about his innovative work to treat autoimmune disease with specifically designed nanoparticles that reprogram the immune system. Miraculously, these immune-modulating nanoparticles are able to both prevent and even reverse immune pathology and resulting neurodegeneration in mouse models of multiple sclerosis.
So basically what they are is a nanoliposome, which is about 100 nanometers in diameter. And that nanoliposome is actually loaded with two specific pieces of information. First of all, it has a small molecule, a chemical, that it's known to induce a tolerogenic response, basically to dampen inflammation. And the second piece of information is an antigen against which we want to tolerize. So that could be a protein, a peptide, or a combination of peptides. By now, what we have is a platform where you can basically plug in your antigen of interest, you know, usually associated to the autoimmune disease or inflammatory condition of interest that you want to target. So in general, what we want is for those particles to release their cargo within dendritic cells, which, as you know, are master regulators of immune responses. Mm-hmm. And the reason for that is because then what we want to do is to turn those dendritic cells into what has been defined as a phenotype of tolerogenic dendritic cells, which have the ability to, instead of boosting, of dampening immune responses. So for example, if we're talking about diabetes, right, these nanoparticles are going to be loaded with a tolerogenic molecule and beta cell specific antigens, for example, insulin, so on and so forth. If we're talking about multiple sclerosis, they will still have the same tolerogenic molecule, but now they will have myelin-derived peptides. We can administer the nanoparticles intramuscularly, IP, subcutaneously, IV. But then what they do is they will control in lymph nodes, right? They will control specific T cell responses, and then the T cells themselves can travel to the target tissue. For example, we just reported these nanoparticles that can tolerize against brain autoimmunity, right? CNS autoimmunity. So we have actually extended this platform to many other inflammatory and autoimmune diseases, right? We have clinical candidates ready to move forward for multiple sclerosis, mm-hmm, and also for inflammatory bowel disease and type 1 diabetes and rheumatoid arthritis.
And yes, our audience can hear more about Dr. Quintana's research during his presentation at the upcoming Joint eSymposia on Neuroimmune Interactions in Neurodegenerative Diseases in June.